Thank you, Mr. Merkin, Ms. DeCetus, Lieutenant Brack, Ms. Hurdle Andy will be back again with us next week.
Thanks ever so much, and good night, everybody. Happy Thanks.
The Price is Right has been brought to you by Pure White Dove, the new bath and beauty bar that's better for your skin than the most expensive soap you can buy. Lever Brothers unconditionally guarantee satisfaction or your money back. The Price is Right is a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production in association with the NBC Television Network. Don Pardo speaking.
Time now for everybody's favorite guessing game, What's My Line? By Remington Rand. Makers of the revolutionary new Remington Rolectric. Now let's all play What's My Line?
And now let's meet our award-winning What's My Line panel. First, the delightful star of stage and television, Miss Arlene Francis.
And now I have an opportunity to do something that I have never done before on this program. I'm going to introduce a young lady who, for 7.5 years, has made an enormous contribution to the success of this program, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Thank you, Arlene. And now I'd like to introduce and at the same time wish many happy returns to our birthday boy. And whatever the birthday is, he doesn't look it. Bennett Cerf.
I have been accorded the privilege of introducing our guest panelist tonight. He's a Hollywood star, a novelist, an adventurer. He's made more girlish hearts flutter even than our own panel moderator, John Daly. I give you Mr. Errol Flynn.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to present you to a gentleman who needs no introduction, so I won't introduce him. John Daly.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to What's My Line. It's going to be fun tonight with Errol Flynn on the panel, finding out whether or not we
fun
can give
us.
Them... Yes, I know. Nice to the two girls particularly. Yeah, Bennett true, yes. Looks a little lonesome over there. But perhaps we can make it an interesting evening for all four of them. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before the panel a little bit later in the show. We meet our first challenger in just 1 minute.
This man has a heavy beard... And this man has a hidden beard, the beard that grows below ordinary shaving level. And this is the only instrument that can shave both beards in absolute comfort, the man-size Remington Rolectric. Now watch. Here, in this magnified close-up, the Rolectric removes that heavy beard in a few seconds. And mind you, chin whiskers are the hardest to shave. The Rolectric can whisk them off because it's man-size, has more live shaving area than any other instrument. And it's comfortable because it's the only shaver with rollers. There, clean as a whistle. Meanwhile, the Rolectric has shaved this man's hidden beard. You can tell by comparing the soft sound of the Rolectric cheek with the scratchy sound of the cheek that merely appeared to be clean shaven. So whether you have a heavy beard or a hidden beard, get the new Remington Rolectric and give yourself a peach of a shave.
Buzzers created the very first ever National Game Show Day.
This is a very, very special day for us.
All day today on Buzzer.
Now let's meet our first contestant. Will you come in and sign in, please?
Mirella? Rocco, is that right? Is it Miss or Mrs.?
It's Miss.
Miss Rocco. Yes. All right, fine. Panel, I will tell you right off the bat that just to make things more interesting, we're not going to ask Miss Rocco where she's from, but Miss Rocco, the panel. Now, will you come over here with me, please?
Are you familiar with the way we keep score?
No, not really.
All righty, then every time you can give the panel a valid no answer, we'll flip the card. 10 flips and you have won the game. So, let's now tell everybody in and out of the theater, except my friends on the panel, exactly what your line is. All right, panel, one bit of help. Miss Rocco is self-employed, and let's begin the general questioning with Bennett, sir.
Miss Rocco, am I correct in assuming that you do not come from the United States?
Yes.
Do you come from a country in Europe?
No.
One down and 9 to go. Miss French.
Miss Rocco, whatever you do, do people watch you when you do it?
Yes.
I should think so. Does it entertain them, what you do?
Yes.
Does it excite them?
Yes.
Do you work at all out of doors?
Yes.
Do you ever work with animals?
Yes.
Have you ever handled a cape?
No.
That's 2 down, 8 to go, Mr. Flynn.
I was on the bull, you know that, of course.
Yes, I know. Too bad it turned out to be a lot off.
You take it by the horns now.
All right, I will try. I'm rather bewildered about this. However, let me see. Is your occupation the kind of thing that might land you in jail if you got caught? Or...
No!
No, I mean, a bullfighter, I thought you. I was following the same theme.
Yes, sir, I was.
3 down and 7 to go, Miss Gilgallon.
Have you ever done whatever it is you do in some country other than the United States?
Yes.
Would it be permissible to do it in the United States?
In general terms, I would say yes, wouldn't you?
Well, yes.
But would you say it was not one of our great national pastimes?
Oh, no.
Yes, I think it would be safe to say it's not one of our great national pastimes, no.
Is it associated with any Latin countries?
Is it associated with any Latin country? I don't believe so, not in any specific terms. This is not to deny that as it's possible to perform these functions here in the United States, they might be, in one term of reference or another, performed in a Latin country, but the specific character of the performance is not normally... Thank you, Father. All right, Bennett?
Miss Rocco, in the work that you do, do you either wrestle or soothe or captivate some kind of a wild animal?
Wrestle or soothe?
Fight with or soothe. I have in mind either fighting with an animal or playing a little tune that makes a cobra dance or something like that.
No snake pit here. That's 5 down and 5 to go, Miss Francis.
Let's get the animal. Is it four-footed?
Yes.
Is it as large as you are?
Oh, yes.
Larger?
Yes.
But not nearly as attractive, Miss Rocco. Does it, is it edible?
Some, oh, yes.
Small conference.
Yeah. Some people eat it all the time, I feel
sometimes.
Sure. What?
Sometimes.
Sometimes, uh-huh. Do you ever touch this animal?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Could you sit on this animal?
Yes.
Yes, at one time or another, it might be possible.
Does it have a hide rather than a furry coat? Is its coat more hide than fur?
We'll have to have a small conference, thank you.
More hide than
more hide than Jekyll. Sometimes. When it's old and gray and the fur falls out. I know how that is. Is it ever seen in the circus, this animal?
Yes.
Would it be considered a wild animal?
Yes.
Is it in the lion or tiger family?
Sometimes.
Oh, once you're in that family, I thought that was for sure, for always. sometimes in that family. And sometimes it travels in another family, huh? Do you perform with this animal, then?
No. That makes it 6-4 to go, Mr. Flynn.
Would it have, Miss Waco, a pair of tusks or a thing that goes like that?
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
Could we have a conference?
You may have 20 seconds for a conference.
Could this sometimes mean that she deals with more than one kind of an animal?
Yes, she has all different kinds of animals out in the jungle, probably.
There's no speciality.
She goes on safari. I can see her now.
No, it's not a rhinoceros.
With Errol Flynn.
Well, not...
All right, the conference.
At least we can be sure it's not a rhinoceros. However, to proceed.
Mr. Flynn, would you like to hazard a guess as to what Miss Rocco's occupation might be?
Yes. I'll hazard a guess, and I'm sure I'm wrong. I think that she is in charge of large animals like camels, elephants, perhaps even rhinoceri.
In charge of them?
I think she's in charge of them.
That'll make it 7-3 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Blue.
Well, I'm going to go on Bennett's hunt and blame him if I'm wrong. Are you a white hunter?
Big game hunter is right. A guide and a hunter on safari on the African continent. We didn't tell you where Miss Rocco was from because if she's from Kenya, that would have given too much away. And so expert, by the way, that... Miss Rocco is a technical consultant for the cinema. I believe you were recently with Beyond Mamba.
Mombasa. Yes, Columbia Production.
Technical consultant. Yes, Bennett.
Safari Sagudi.
Miss Rocco, all I can say is I'm sorry that that is the memory of us that you must carry away. Thank you very much for being our guest. Will you say goodnight to the family?
We'll be right back.
panel. Did rather well with that one, I think. Let's see what you can do with our second challenger. Would you come in and sign in, please? Marjorie Cook, is that right? Miss or Mrs. Cook? Mrs. Cook, and where are you from?
Munson,
Massachusetts. Mrs. Cook, the panel, Mrs. Cook, and now will you join me over here? Do you know how we keep score?
Yes, I do.
Fine. Then let's let everybody at home and our friends who've joined us in the theater know exactly what your line is. Panel, Mrs. Cook is salaried, and let's begin the general questioning with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Mrs. Cook, do you work for a profit-making organization?
Yes.
Is there a product involved in what you do? Would you call it a useful product?
Yes.
Is it anything that Mr. Flynn could use?
Will you repeat that, please? I don't know.
So your fun comes later, Errol, but
no,
it's something...
No, I didn't hear it. I know I can use it,
yes.
Perhaps, but...
is it something that I could hold in my hand?
Yes.
Is it something that would be found in millions of American homes?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Mr. Sir.
Mrs. Munson, can we assume... Mrs. Cook, I mean, you're from Munson.
Yes.
Where is Munson?
Well, it's between Springfield and Worcester.
Up along around Deerfield and Greenfield. Can we assume that this object of, with which you're connected is inanimate?
Yes.
Is it a manufactured object?
Yes.
Does it help a person to do something? Like a...
Yes.
I would say that would be a reasonable explanation in many conditions, that it helped a person to do something, yeah.
Would it be, have anything to do, I just not why this popped into my mind, would it have anything to do with telling time or...
Telling time?
Yes.
That, no, not at all. That's what I think. That's $2.08 to go. Miss Francis.
Is this product consumed?
No.
$3.07 to go. Mr. Flint.
Is it used on the body, Mrs. Cook?
Yes.
Now try to think of what you've used on your body, because it's something you could use.
I can think of too many things. Leave me alone for a moment. Many useful devices. However, Mrs. Cook, would you say that this was something to, like a lotion?
Like
no.
A lotion? No. No lotion. $4.06 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Is it solid rather than liquid?
Yes.
Is the purpose other than beautification?
Yes.
Is it other than health?
Yes.
Does this have any moving parts?
Yes.
Could it in some circumstances be dangerous?
No.
Small conference.
Yes.
To be perfectly fair, Dorothy, I think we should give you a no answer, but there is the possibility that it can be used, the object can be used, so that it would have certain dangerous connotations. Since this is so, would you like to proceed?
Well, then, in ordinary use, for instance, could I use this product?
Yes.
Well, if I used it, I wouldn't necessarily get into trouble with it.
No.
No, you wouldn't get into trouble with it, no.
Not if it's a knife.
Well, it has moving parts. Can it be used without attaching it to any electrical outlet?
Yes.
Well, when you use it, does it do anything?
Yes.
Does it do anything to a person?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Is this usually to yourself rather than to another person?
No. Five down and five.
Next, it's a password double play, and nothing says the 60s like Alan Ludden styling that skinny tie. He's so cool. National Game Show Decades Day continues. Stay tuned.
Mm-hmm.
does something to another person then when you're using it. Do you attach it to yourself when you're using it in any way?
Sometimes.
Would you use it in a hostile manner? When you're in a belligerent mood, would you use this object?
It is possible that there may have been induced prior to its use what you describe as a belligerent mood, and that it might be used while the mood was still present.
Would you use it in connection with your hands when you're using it?
Yes.
Would this object penetrate the epidermis of a person?
No.
Six down and 42.
How do you like
I'm
that?
Going to give you one more minute. Miss Francis?
Would it have the same effect on somebody as a straitjacket?
The same effect on somebody as
I mean, would it restrain someone?
Yes.
Is it something that is used occasionally by the police department?
Yes.
Is it ever, instead of on the hand, is it sometimes on the wrist?
Yes.
Is it handcuffed?
Handcuffed, right. Arlene, one small technicality. What does Mrs. Cook have to do with handcuffs?
Well, she tests them to see that the lock works.
No. That makes it seven down and three to go, Mr. Flynn.
Would she be in charge of putting handcuffs on ladies?
No. That's eight down and two to go, Miss Kilgallen.
I'm goofing,
she
horribly.
She makes them, right. Fine. Actually, Mrs. Cook thinks you're uncanny. And I think so, too. And I guess Smith and Wesson probably figure that handcuffs do, after all, get used in a belligerent sense sometimes. Will you agree with that?
Yes.
I hope so, because I don't want your folks to be mad at me. Thanks very much for being our guest. Will you say goodnight to the panel? In just a moment, we'll meet tonight's mystery guest, but first here is a message from Remington Rand.
This man who's been out fishing is ready for a good, clean shave. What's he using? The Remington Auto Home Rolectric. Just plug it into the cigarette lighter socket of your car, and it changes automatically from home to car voltage. It works equally well at home and in your car. See how quickly it goes after that heavy beard? That's because it's man size. It has more live shaving area than any other instrument. Even the heaviest beard rolls right off. But the new Auto Home Rolectric does more than shave any man's heavy beard. With its exclusive roller combs, it can also shave every man's hidden beard, the beard below ordinary shaving level. It's really such a great shaver, I hardly have to say a word. Uh-oh. He forgot to shave that patch of beard on his left cheek. Now then, if it can shave the hidden beard, that means you get longer-lasting shaves all day. There, now he's getting that patch. And it's a really clean shave. And mind you, a beautiful shave like this can now be enjoyed at home, in your car, wherever you go. Now, wouldn't it be a good idea to give Dad the pleasure of a shave like that, starting with Father's Day? Well, give him a new Remington Auto Home Rolectric, or the standard model Rolectric. And give him a peach of a shave.
Mark your calendars. It's a great day. You're watching Buzzer's National Game Show Day Celebration.
Now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity, for which I ask my friends on the panel, to please blindfold themselves. Blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes, yes, sir.
All right, will you come in, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? Panel, as you know, in the case of our mystery challenger, we go to a different form of questioning. You ask one question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise, and we begin with Arlene Francis.
Are you a shining light in the entertainment world?
I don't know.
The answer to that is yes. Mr. Flynn?
Have you ever had claustrophobia? I'm getting it right now. are you in the theatrical profession, sir?
Yes, I am.
Miss Kilgallen?
Are you more stage than movies?
More stage than movies?
Yes.
Mr. Sir?
Have you ever appeared in television? A couple of times.
Miss Francis?
Have you ever appeared in musical comedies?
Yeah.
Mr. Flynn?
Gangster?
No.
That's one down of nine to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Are you more the drawing room comedy type?
More the what?
Sounds like it.
Drawing room comedy type.
Well, I don't know. I might be.
I think that actually, in the context of the question, we'd better answer it no, or we might confuse them if it's acceptable to you. That makes it two down and eight to go, Mr. Sir.
Have you ever done any work in the nightclubs of America?
On occasion.
Are you a dancer?
Mr. Flynn?
What is that? I didn't
that means
that.
Yes.
Ventriloquist?
No.
3,007 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
John, could I have a ruling on dancer? Does that mean that primarily a dancer?
The question we just asked, are you a dancer? And the answer to that was yes.
Well, then... Would you say that in musical comedy you have done more dancing than singing?
No.
That makes it four down and six to go, Mr. Seraph.
Are you primarily known for something other than either dancing or singing? I don't hear anything.
Bennett, I think that properly we answer that question yes, but we do it with... A small reservation. Mrs. Francis?
Have you been appearing at a nightclub in New York in the last month?
Yeah, I guess I am.
Mr. Flynn?
I'm lost unless he's Mickey Rooney's son.
We'll call a pass. Miss Kilgallen?
Have you made any records? I mean, the kind that are played on jukeboxes.
Oh, well, yes, I've made a few. I've really done that.
Mr. Sir?
What?
Yes, yes.
Have you got anything to do with a band?
No, I haven't got nothing to do with a band.
That makes it five down and five to go, Miss Francis.
Are you a dazzling entertainer, known part of the last year as Mr. Wonderful, and continue to do so as long as you perform, Sammy Davis?
That's right, Sammy Davis Jr. You just saw Bennett on the plane?
Yeah, we shook hands.
In Cincinnati.
Oh, that's wonderful. Actually, we thought that you had it. You know, when you went to... You're known for primarily something else, and there was the issue of the impressions, which Sammy Davis Jr.
I didn't know what he did in the nightclub.
Oh, that's great.
I'd like him to dance off when he makes his exit tonight.
I'll be happy to.
He just finished at the Copacabana, which is what you were after,
yes,
I think.
Yes, that was it.
And Mr. Wonderful, you did that for a full year on Broadway.
Fortunately,
you told me you were going to Indianapolis.
Well, I went to Indianapolis. We're on a one-night tour now. And tomorrow, as a matter of fact, I'm in Cincinnati. I appeared there for one night.
Well, when did you meet Bennett in Cincinnati?
I went there to do some engagement publicity, and we met at the airport. He almost missed his plane, too.
That's right.
That's fine. This is, you know, we very rarely stick Bennett this way, Sam. So this is nice to know that we got him. And
I had
him
somewhere off in the Midwest.
Of course, the thing that I thought gave... Arlene, did you get it because of the impression of...
No, I got it from the voice.
You got it from the voice?
But didn't I, Sammy?
You started doing Jimmy Stewart.
I started doing Jimmy Stewart. I figured I might be able to throw it off a little bit.
Do a little bit of Jimmy Stewart again.
Oh, gee whiz, it's really been a wonderful pleasure. I was positive that Miss Kilgallen was going to get it this time. I was really just positive that she would get it. I sit in amazement with my grandmother and watch the program, and she always gets all of the performance. You know? Yeah. And you didn't get the...
Bad night, Sammy, but I was getting that you were a singer.
Yeah.
And that's pretty accurate.
And that's about the nicest compliment you can give me.
Well, thank you very much for being our guest.
Thank you.
And for bringing this wonderful... multifaceted talent as you are to What's My Line, because I know you probably like to have had Sunday off with a lot
Thank
of other
you.
People.
Thank you.
Good to see
you.
Until next week, this is John Daly saying good night, Miss Arlene.
Good night, John. Good night, Errol. Have a good trip.
Good night, Dorothy. Thank you very much.
Nice to have you with us.
Thank you, my dear Dorothy.
Good
night, Thank
Errol.
You, Johnny.
Thank Come you, again. Bennett. Good night, Bennett.
Good night, fellow genius, Mr. Daly.
Thank you, Bennett. And Errol, it has been wonderful having you with us. You looked as though you enjoyed yourself, and that, I think, is why we enjoyed having you so much. Thanks
Thank you, John. I got a bit stuck in the beginning. I can do it better next time. Let's start all over, eh?
Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for being with us on What's My Line.
This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. In association with the CBS Television Network. Be sure to see Remington Rand's other great television program, Gunsmoke, Saturday night on this same network.